metal. That's not metal. That's not metal. You're the podcast. That's not metal. That's not metal. That's not metal. You're the podcast.
Hi everyone, Beez here from the That's Not Metal podcast. I'm here at Marshall HQ. We are here for the first ever That's Not Metal session as powered by Marshall. We are joined today by one of the best new bands in heavy music around the globe. They are Venom Prison. Here's my co-host, Mr. Stephen Hill, to tell you a little bit more about them.
We want to bring you the best and most cutting-edge bands around and throwing you in at the deep end of Venom Prison. They're one of the world's most boundary-pushing extreme metal bands, melding the death metal of Cryptopsy and Suffocation with the sludgy hardcore of Desolated and Nasty. The band's debut album, Animus, was one of the finest blasts of extreme metal from 2016, and they're here to rip your skull off and launch it into outer space. Yes, literally, this is death metal.
Okay, we welcome Larissa and Ash to the show from Venom Prison. How did it come to be that you started Venom Prison? Because I know that you were both involved in other projects first. Particularly know you, Ash, from Brutality Will Prevail. How did it come to be that you put this together? Was it down to frustrations in other projects, or what? Where was the formation?
Well, I left the band I was previously in just because, you know, I wanted to do something different. But in the end, I ended up moving to Germany, and that
went
off subject. So I kind of sat in the apartment I lived in on my own, just writing songs and stuff. And then finally, I was like, found out we were moving back to Wales. And I was like, okay, been putting these demos together. So I messaged Ben and was just like, you playing in the band? And his band had just finished as well. And we were just like, let's put a band together, did that. And, you know, you've left your band.
And my band.
Everyone left their bands.
But was the aim to start playing something different? Because this is a different brand of, like, you're all involved with heavy music, but this is a different brand for all of you.
I think I was just frustrated with hardcore. I thought it was boring at that time, and kind of still is.
Is that what it is? Because Steve's going to love this, my co-host. But I have this thing with him all the time where I say all the best hardcore bands leave hardcore. So, like, is it just a thing where it's quite a restrictive art form, and once you've been playing it for a couple of years, you want to do more?
I think when I was playing in a hardcore band, I always liked metal. I got into metal before hardcore.
Right.
So for me, it made a lot of sense, like, just to do that, because that's what I wanted to do. You know, when you do your first band, and, you know, depending what it is, you kind of go with what your mates want to do type thing. Just do a majority vote, and that's what your band is, you know. But then this time I could make my mind up what it was, and this is how this is, you know, what it is. Just because I finally was able to start a band and say, look, I want to do a metal band, this is it. And that was it. And then I, you know, asked everyone, and they were all down for it.
And is it that the blending of death metal and hardcore are the two main ingredients that I hear now? This is the real melding of death metal and hardcore, because we've had years of deathcore being thrown around as a term, which is basically like new metal with the odd death metal lick and sub drops and monster energy drinks. is this a real melding of those two styles? Do you feel that there's as much of one as there is the other in your band, or does one outweigh the other? Or
No, I would say, like, when I listen to songs, especially like heavier stuff, I like pace, I like energy, you know. I like to see sometimes a bit of groove in something, you know. Like,
absolutely
not like, even if it wasn't related to like hardcore music, just like, you know, when you listen to something heavy, you want to wait for that groove to come, or you want to wait for that pace to pick up. And I think that's kind of what we base the band around, like, you know, keeping that energy up with it and stuff. And then us doing hardcore bands before, obviously that's what hardcore bands are all about, so it was obvious to us to be like, right, this is how you do this. And then not doing 45 minute solos and boring the shit out of everyone.
There is that as well,
like, you know. So this is kind of how this come together and melted, and that's how we wrote the album, all the songs we've done since.
Was it something that was easy to fit around as a vocalist as well?
It was for me, because I've always liked writing lyrics that are a bit metaphorical, which is a bit difficult and hard sometimes because not everyone understands. So I really enjoyed doing the vocals and recording them for this record, because I would go myself a bit more and just try new things, which I couldn't before.
Well, I'm going to ask you about a lot of those new things in the next part, but what's the first song you're going to play for us?
Abysmal Agony.
Yeah, Abysmal Agony.
What makes you pick that first? What made you pick that as one of the three songs you're going to play for us off the record Animus today?
It's
the first song on the record.
Yeah.
It was the first single that we released.
First single we did release.
And it's like a brick to the face.
That's a good description. I'll use that. Welcome back to That's Not Metal, powered by Marshall. So, about the record, Larissa, did you expect it to pick up as much controversy as it has because of the lyrical content? Like, to me, I just wanted to put my interpretation out first, because it's something a bit different to what I've read elsewhere, and that's that it's the same thematically as what's been going on in death metal for years. It's literally just gender reversal. Like, so to me, it's not that big a deal. So why do you think it is that everyone has kind of lost their shit about it? I've not seen for a while, so much debate caused over a new band. It's cool.
I don't actually know why, because I didn't expect that myself. For me as well, it was just something from my perspective, but basically the same thing, really, just like you said. But I think because metal as well as hardcore, is pretty male dominated by men. I think a lot of people feel like you're taking something away from them just because you're a woman, but there's really no difference. Like, it doesn't make a difference if I have a penis or a vagina.
Yeah.
It's just about what I sing about or what I can do.
Have you felt a lot of that? Do you feel like you've upset the apple cart a little?
Yeah, especially after that Metal Hammer article and all the comments
on that
Facebook.
That was literally what I was referring to, because it blew my mind. Like, was that a shock to you as a band? Like, because it feels like, what do you know about Venom Prison? Ah, they're the band with the guy who's had his gizzards cut off and being fed to him on the front cover. Now, like, Cannibal Corpse, Butchered at Birth, it's babies. It's dead babies hanging from everywhere, and, like, no one goes, oh, that's fucking deplorable or whatever. Like, it's such a head fuck to me.
Yeah, I don't know. I think it's really just because you're not a guy.
Mm.
That's how it feels like to me. Like, I'm used to all the comments because I was in bands before, and it's a reoccurring thing for me, so I don't take that really personal or serious.
So,
yeah.
Is it enjoyable to write as well?
Yeah, especially now, because, you know, it's pissing people off. Like, that's probably something that I want to do in the future as well.
What song are you going to pick next?
Next song is Wormforced Animus.
I know, and can you tell us a bit about that song thematically on that motif?
That one is about, specifically, it's about religion and the female role within religion, because you have female demons which reoccur through different kinds of religions, like Christianity and in Hebrew religions and stuff like that. And they're basically the same demons, they have different names, and they are prescribed to be, like, they're described to be bad for humanity, and they just want to destroy humankind. But in my opinion, I see them differently. I think they're there to take revenge on something that's been happening throughout history, like rape or patriarchy. And
would you describe yourself as an angry vocalist, as an angry lyricist?
I would say so. Yeah.
Like, is there, as a woman, is there plenty to be angry about, and is that anger fueled by years of playing in bands? Because, like, it's funny. Like, I didn't know what to expect coming in here, because we've never met before, and it was like, it feels that way. It feels like someone that has a lot to say, and that it comes from a place of real. Fuck this.
Yeah, definitely. Like, I've had enough. Like, I've been making music for 10 years, and things like that has been happening all the time, and there is enough reason for women to be angry today, just like thousands of years ago, and why shouldn't we?
Do you think it'll ever get better? Is it getting any better?
It is getting better, because it's getting more attention now, and I think that's something that changes how people think about things.
Here's something to get your attention. Right, final part. Have you been staggered by the attention that you guys have got? Because your album is gnarly as fuck. Super heavy. Like, there's no punches pulled. But there's been real attention on the band in the first couple of months. Because, I mean, literally, like, as of January 2017, you've only been a band for 2 years, right? Like, how quickly this has come since the record dropped? Has that been a real sign of the times? Because from my perspective, having worked in the media, in rock and metal, here for this amount of time, for 15 years or so, it feels like now there's a real groundswell of organic bands. Like, people are kind of fed up of being force-fed, overproduced, shiny, poppy music, even in the world of metal, like things that have been popped up. Do you think it's a sign of the times that Venom Prison have really captured people's imaginations?
Yeah, I'd say so. Like, you know, we haven't gone for that overproduced thing, that overpolished, like, you know, deathcore-y. Even though I did see someone say that we are, like, what he thinks a definition of deathcore should be.
I'd agree. Well, yeah, it is. It's death metal and hardcore. Like, in the real world, that's what it should be. It's become a dirty term because...
Which I find is really weird when you get these deathcore bands and, you know, like, I don't even know how to describe them. Like, you know, just that whole...
I do.
That whole over-polished beat
Monster
down-y,
energy.
Like,
exactly, that.
Monster energy. And I think, like, you know, all of us in this band, we all like, you know, our metal and stuff, like, even... you know, older stuff like Bolt Thrower, Carcass, Napalm Death, these are all British bands, you know?
Amen.
And it's like, you know, we like these bands and it's like, you know, we don't have to follow this over-polished thing just because it's 2016 or something, you know what I mean? Those albums still sound great now, like, you know, 10, 15, 20 years later.
Exactly.
I think that's like what we wanted to do, you know? We wanted to be that band that's like, you know, why can't we sound like that?
Was Damnation Festival a real moment for you guys as well? Because, like, I wasn't at the festival, but because we've said nice things about your band, when your set finished, my Twitter timeline blew up like the fucking Death Star, with people just going, they've just levelled the place. Like, did that feel like a standout? What have been the standout moments in the 2 years that we look at Venom Prison? What have been the standout moments for you guys?
For me, that Damnation show was probably my favourite show to play with Venom Prison so far. It felt really good and the sound was amazing. The room was filled with people and...
Don't forget the lights.
Lights were
If you
great.
Have the lights, you're capable of an epileptic fit, then it's a good show.
Shout out Cult of Luna.
Best moments, like, you know, since we started, we haven't stopped. There hasn't been a week where we haven't got together, if we're writing or playing shows or on tour and stuff. So, like, we haven't really got time to sit back and be like, oh, that was a great time. You know, it's like, you've done it, get on with the next thing, you know?
This 2017 threatened loads more. Like, have you felt doors opening for the band in the last couple of months?
Yeah.
Like, we're here at Marshall HQ doing something like this. Yeah, like does it feel like there's more mounting up?
Yeah, it's great. Like, you know, when we come into this, we just wrote an album, you know? Like, it wasn't...
Yeah.
We just wrote an album. Like, it wasn't...
Well, your first demo was recorded in your front room, was it not?
Yeah, I did it.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then we did, like, the 7-inch with our friend in his studio, and then Prosthetic said, do you want to do the album? We were just like, oh, fuck, do you know about us?
Yeah.
You know, like... So then we just, you know, we wrote an album for the label. That's all you can do. And then what comes after it is just, you know, if people react to it well or they don't or thing. But I think, you know, as a record, there's quite a lot of elements other than just the music. You know, like we were saying, like, lyrical content is very strong.
The artwork.
So the whole aesthetic to it kind of, like, flow together really nicely.
It's definitely a complete package.
Yeah.
Like, I feel like I know what your band's about. Like, even you look at that cover and you go, like, from logo to image, like, you get a real feel for what Venom Prison is. Like, it's a well-rounded package, I'd have to say.
It's like the artwork doing that, you know.
We didn't even plan the artwork to be like it is. Wanted the artist to make something great for us, and he's read through the lyrics, and that's what struck him the most. And I think he was right.
I like the melding of the death metal imagery and the fact that it looks religious.
Yeah.
Because when you mention religion, and like I've seen it written a lot about that there's political elements to the record as well. Is that can you talk us through that? I mean, it's almost impossible in the current climate. It's impossible to be angry and not attach that to politics. But like, what side of that?
Well, I grew up an anarchist. I still kind of am in my heart, and that's just something that always strives me. And I'm sick of living in the world. It's just not fair.
You grew up as an anarchist. Yeah. Can I ask a little more about that? How so?
Well, I was hanging out with punks when I was younger, and I grew up in Germany as well. Mm. We were going to demonstrations almost every week. And
what sort of things were you?
Well, just demonstrating against Nazis, because there's a lot of them in Germany, and at that time, like over 10 years ago, it was happening almost every weekend that they would just show up somewhere to make trouble, and we didn't want that to happen.
Yeah.
All kinds of riots and demonstrations as well, and yeah.
Unbelievable. Well, we will pick this up another time. Let's do this chatting another time. What's the final track that you're going to play for us?
It's going to be Devoid.
Here it is, Devoid. that's all for today. We have to thank Venom Prison for joining us on the That's Not Metal session, and you should join us on the That's Not Metal podcast. There's a new episode every single Friday where we discuss that week's reviews, bring you the most honest opinions you will hear anywhere, and the new bands that you need to be checking it out. Anything that's happening in rock music that week, we will be covering it on the That's Not Metal podcast. Do go and check it out on iTunes and SoundCloud. Me and Stephen Hill will see you there, and we'll also see you back here at Marshall HQ for more That's Not Metal sessions in the future. That's not metal, that's not metal, that's not metal, you're debarred.